Very sad story. Mississippi trooper decides to physically assault a handcuffed black male and then proceed to arrest individuals who are recording this assault. All right. There's a viral video from McComb, Mississippi. It shows a Mississippi Highway Patrol officer beating a handcuffed suspect on the side of the road. Here's the first video.
This man just got through jumping on this man while he was in the car, y'all. Hey, yeah, you we looking at you choke the man. That's why you told us to stop. We looking at you choke the man. We gonna stay back, but we gonna record you. We gonna record you. We wanna know why you was in that car. But we wanna know why you was in the car jumping on him. We wanna know why you was in the car jumping on him. We wanna know why you was in the car jumping on him.
Put your hand on me, bro. Hey, who you here, bro?
Just wait. Man, don't grab my, hey man, don't do that, bro. Hey, I got him on live. I got his ass on live. He got a handcuff, man. You said you ain't had no business jumping on him. You ain't had no business jumping on him. Look at this. Look at this, man. Look at this, y'all. Look at this. He got on handcuffs.
Yeah, bitch.
We don't care. You need to be gone.
Very sad. I have more video and more egregious activity from the police. The individual they were assaulting, his name is Eugene Lewis. Eugene Lewis was in handcuffs, okay? And individuals standing by were recording. These were his brothers. There was a back and forth between law enforcement and the brothers. Here it is.
Hey, you remember John Floyd? That's how John Floyd died right there. Hey, he got handcuffs on him. You was in the car jumping on him. You shut up. Ain't no shut up. We don't give a damn. You were just in the back seat beating him out.
Man,
take us to jail. We don't mind going to jail. But this ain't right. We just caught the state trooper in the back seat. He ran us off. He was in the back seat beating him up.
We ain't did nothing.
You done threw him down, now he gotta get up. Get on, let the man break your wrist, man. The man trying to hurt you, bro. He gotta be the police, cause when he came, look at this. He kicking him, man.
The men who decided to stay are good men. They knew what they were sacrificing potentially by remaining there. The officer said, y'all going to jail. No criminal activity had taken place between those recording and the police. They stayed far back and engaged in recording, which they are legally allowed to do in the state of Mississippi. According to the men, they actually caught this particular Mississippi state trooper beating up their brother in the back seat of the vehicle. And they decided to start recording. They wanted to know why. Why was this happening? Why were they engaged in this kind of criminal activity? The officer then proceeds to tell them, you better leave, basically. You better leave, because if you're here when the cops show up, you're going to jail. He wanted them to be gone. He wanted them to exit the area. He wanted them to shut up about what they saw. They said, we're okay with going to jail. We're okay. We're not going anywhere. We don't care if the cops are coming. We're gonna wait on them. The scene continues with a white bystander taking the side of the officer before the officer starts to approach the brothers. Here it is.
What you asking? You said what you need me to help you do?
Police officer, bro. So I don't know him, but you don't know him.
Call him. He jumping on our brother. If somebody's jumping on you,
I'm just standing here.
It's
bro.
Our brother.
If somebody,
but he ain't asked you to leave now. Time
yelling at
you. Man, you.
He ain't asked you to leave now.
No, hey, we still got you.
For what?
So we don't care.
For what?
Sir,
for what?
We ain't did nothing.
For
For what?
We ain't did nothing.
For what?
For recalling you.
For recalling you?
No, sir.
Oh, you going to jail?
I tell you right now, y'all still here when these other folks get here. Y'all going to jail.
We wait on the police. We going to show this video.
We record what you doing.
All we doing, record what you doing.
You going first.
We waiting on them.
Don't get in that car.
This is so damn sad. They are engaged in legal behavior. Recording a public official, recording a cop, is 100% legal in the state of Mississippi. But these cops wanted to put them in their place. A white male bystander starts to interfere, and he's not told to get back in his car. The white male bystander is not told to be quiet. He's escalating things. The white male bystander is not told, listen, you need to stop because this is not making things better. He was allowed to walk freely, to proceed to go up and down that street freely with absolutely no rebuttal from law enforcement. I have more. Once again, let's put up the picture of the man they assaulted, Mr. Eugene Lewis. Okay. Eugene told WJTV he didn't know what would have happened to his, had his brother Packer not Facebook live streamed the incident. He said the officer first pulled him over for allegedly doing 35 in a 30. I can't never let this go, he said. I ain't did nothing to him. I know this same white guy would do another black guy like that. The video runs a little more than 5 minutes. Packer and Darius Lewis, Eugene's brothers, can be heard in the background narrating the officer's actions and exchanging words from time to time. From the video, the two stay back away from the officer and their brother, but they refuse to budge, right? They stay far enough away not to interfere with the investigation, which is the criminal dynamic. They stay far away. No criminal act has taken place. All three brothers were arrested. Let's put up a picture of Packer Lewis. Packer Lewis, the man you're looking at, took to Facebook following his release from jail. In a post, he said, quote, "We don't need officers here to protect and serve like this trooper. I stayed in jail for a couple of days for absolutely nothing. Sad, but it's the world we live in." Mayor Lockley confirmed the incident involved a Mississippi Highway Patrol officer. Put up a picture of the mayor. Now, according to the mayor, because this incident involved a state employee, he is letting the state handle the investigation. Cop out, Mayor Lockley, because you have what's called concurrent jurisdiction for your investigative authorities to also investigate what happened in your city. Because the people who elected you and the people you appointed to enforce the law, they have jurisdiction here to investigate what happened. But you are copping out. Although outside of his jurisdiction, he wanted assurances it would be investigated. He said, quote, "This is alarming that something like this would happen within the city limits of McComb. And remember, once again, because it happened within the city limits, he has concurrent jurisdiction to launch an investigation. He is choosing not to. So while the narrative is outside of his jurisdiction by way of employment, the employment is outside of his jurisdiction, but the activity of the cop is not. Colonel Randy Jen, director of the Mississippi Highway Patrol, has put up his picture. So old Colonel Jen here, who's also the assistant commissioner of the Mississippi Department of Public Safety, oversees the Bureau of Investigation. Both the Internal Affairs and the Mississippi Bureau of Investigations are investigating the incident. The assaulting officer remains unidentified intentionally by law enforcement. Now, I want you to remember the white male bystander who just got out of his car, decided to get himself involved and received absolutely no rebuttal from law enforcement. You see, white men in particular, they feel empowered to come against black males, especially if they are in a conflict with law enforcement. Not to stay out of it, not to be thoughtful about their engagement, but to literally come after black people as if it is open season on black men who may have an engagement or encounter with law enforcement. Let me show you a video of a civilian who decides to kneel on the back of a man who's already pinned down by the police. What do you think this attitude comes from? What do you think this sentiment comes from? It comes from this notion that somehow white men and police departments are basically empowered to be antithetical to black lives. What other excuse is there? What other reasoning? What other conclusion can you come to? All right, this happened at the Broadway Lafayette street stop. What are your thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, this really speaks to something that's really important. So like I'll contextualize this with data. In Tennessee, Mississippi, and Alabama, somewhere between 8-10% of the entire voting age population, the entire voting age population is denied the right to vote due to felony-like voting laws, due to felony voting laws and current incarceration. That is not a mistake. That is not a mistake. When people think of southern states, they often think of a lot of racists. But what we really need to think of is the brutal repression of black folks in those states and the explicit aim from the government to enact an extreme amount of violence and disenfranchise people from the political process entirely.